Running a major transport hub like an airport is extremely intensive operationally. Thousands of processes are happening at any moment, and disruptions such as delays and accidents can critically impact operational health. If not managed properly, things quickly spiral out of control, and to make matters worse, transparency and traceability are often lacking. Thus, highly challenging to identify causes and implement fixes. In this video, I'll showcase how a low-code custom app built on ServiceNow, leveraging generative AI, can address these challenges. For our use case today, we will explore a journey across two groups of airside staff. Steve is a member of the ground handling staff, and Carmen is an airside operations supervisor. What has happened here is a delay in disembarkation for flight BR215 due to equipment fault. And that has caused a series of other events that Steve now has to report to Carmen for visibility. Through our custom app, we're setting out to solve a few questions. How can we consolidate all the different reporting channels into one single source of truth? How can we then use all the data to make contextual recommendations? Where do we use generative AI to enhance and augment the experience for all users involved? And finally, how can we provide better visibility overall? We'll first start as Steve, who intends to create a new situation report for flight BR215. We see the form here, where he's able to indicate that it is a new situation that he's reporting, and to fill in all the details regarding this incident, which includes text explaining the time of the incident, as well as what happened following this disembarkation delay. After submitting this report, we switch over to Carmen, who is now in her airside operations dashboard. This will be her control center to check all incidents airside, and the dashboard was easily built with Dashboard Builder. Carmen opens up the report by Steve for BR215. This looks like a normal workspace, but many components here are actually powered by AI, whether it is ServiceNow-specific AI or generative AI. The first thing we can do here is click on the button for Summarize Record. What this does is it takes the description that Steve enters and gives a shorter summary for Carmen to process. So imagine if there is a very lengthy report entered, this becomes a highly useful tool to create a short-form version of the text. Before we move on to more Gen AI features, also note that there are SLAs being triggered here for this situation report, and those can be configured according to the different types of incidents. On the right side panel, we have also set up a playbook that can guide Carmen and the team to work through different situations. Some of the steps here include sending emails to involve personnel, and even automatically creating a Microsoft Teams chat related to this incident where all the airside staff can actively report on any updates. The idea here is that all communication can be synced back to ServiceNow, and then that data can be processed by AI to pick out the key events and messages related to this incident. Let's also not forget about Agent Assist, which takes the short description from this record and can recommend a variety of resources to help Carmen with handling this situation. For example, here we can see a list of recommended knowledge articles related to disembarkation delays. The AI search on ServiceNow is also able to quickly associate this record with other similar incidents based on natural language understanding. Very powerful, especially if there is someone new to the team who needs to have these different resources recommended to them, given that they are still unfamiliar with the internal processes. So back to the main workspace, you might be curious as to what that Open Airside Intelligence purple button does. Let's have a look. Clicking on it opens up another UI Builder page, and this page was built with the intention of being the mission control for a parent airside incident. Right now, there's not a whole lot going on, but you can see that based on what Steve had entered, the timeline had already populated with three key events that were observed. The first was for the delay start, the next was for the technician's fix, and the last one was when the disembarkation actually began. Obviously, Gen AI is powering the creation of these events, and I'll talk about how it was achieved in the last part of today's video. For now, let's create another related incident against this disembarkation delay. It was found that there was a separate flight, AK713, which could not get to the gate due to the ongoing blockage from BR215. As a result, it could not take off on its scheduled time and required a gate change as well. So note how we tag this to the parent BR215 situation report. Now that we've submitted this new related report, we come back to our incident intelligence dashboard. You will start to see a few things to update. Firstly, the component on the right updates to show that a new related incident had been recorded. On the left, you can see that the Now Assist Summary component updates to summarize what has been observed across the two major events. Lastly, the top timeline bar updates to include the new events coming from the reported takeoff delay of AK713. So basically, every component that you see on this dashboard here is powered by GenAI. Let's add another related situation report, this time manually. The situation this time would be that a passenger was causing a commotion due to the delay of AK713. Heading back to our dashboard, you can once again see that all components being refreshed, factoring in the new information from the report that we had just created. The idea here is that there can be an indefinite number of related events, and it will always update this dashboard in real time to give the most relevant information to Carmen and her team. Back on the master record, since we now have more data, we can also start to ask questions about all the information available. So for example, which flights were impacted? Or we can ask, how many passengers were affected by this event in total? Basically, generative AI is able to intelligently make use of all the data that we have at hand and to help Carmen with critical questions that she would otherwise have to piece together manually. I hope by now you all see how generative AI can deliver some very quick wins with the custom apps that you're building, and it's really up to your imagination and creativity to find these pockets to work alongside users and to add value to their work. On to how this application was built. We find ourselves once again in App Engine Studio, where you can see three tables here, with the most important one being the situation report table. Extended from the task table, this helped power much of the standard logic we needed in our workspace. So about that workspace, the incident intelligence dashboard screen was created as a custom page, which will open up from this button component. The timeline component actually takes event data from a JSON payload. So typically, this will require some GraphQLs and transform data, but here, I'm storing this JSON payload in a custom field, and the component will take the data from this field. You're probably guessing that the JSON payload is generated by generative AI, and you're right. In this flow, we're defining that every time there are updates to the record, we will use the generate content action to generate the timeline JSON payload. This action is one of the four actions currently available in generative AI controller. The prompt here basically tells GenAI to extract the key events from the reports, examine the sample from the timeline JSON payload, and then transform the events into the required format. Taking this output, it will then update the JSON field on the situation report table. You can see one of the executions here on the successfully generated JSON payload. Next was that related report summary component. This is powered by the summarize action. And what the whole flow does is look up all the descriptions from the parent as well as the child records, pass that into generative AI, which will then summarize all these content before updating the record. That's simple enough. The last component here would be the Now Ask capability. The idea for this one is similar to the summarize action, but this time, we pass the content into the Q&A action instead. What this does is it looks at the entire content given, and then takes a question from the user about this content and will intelligently pass in a response to the user. Very useful when someone like Carmen needs quick answers without having to look through all the information. So that's it, a custom app completely built with low-code on ServiceNow and powered by generative AI. There are limitless possibilities for so many different use cases, and this is really only the beginning of the revolution. Like all of you watching, I'm so excited for what's in store next. So until next time, this is Xiao. No code, no problem.